Amber, which is fossilized wood resin of extinct tree species, is not only known as a gemstone, but also for its inclusion of animals like insects or lizards. It can also contain plants or fungi, which is the scientific term for mushrooms. So, why is that interesting? Mushrooms are not only a popular food source for animals, including ourselves, but also an important symbiont of most terrestrial plants. We call the symbiotic partnership mycorrhiza. The name mycorrhiza comes from the ancient Greek words mykes for mushroom and rhiza for root. In this symbiosis, the fungi help the plants to retrieve minerals and water from the soil, while the plants provide the fungi with photosynthetic nutrients such as sugars. In addition, the mycorrhiza protect the plants against diseases, like parasites, and are thus essential for a functioning ecosystem. An example for the importance of mycorrhiza symbionts are orchids, which cannot germinate without the presence of the right fungi partner. There are two different forms of mycorrhiza, endo- and ectomycorrhiza. The ectomycorrhiza hyphae, which are the fungal cell filaments, form a mantle around the root tips and a so-called Harting net around the root cells, but normally don't enter them. The endomycorrhiza hyphae, on the other hand, penetrate the cell walls of the plant. Today, ectomycorrhiza are most common in boreal and temperate forests. So, back to Amber. About 10 years ago, scientists found an ectomycorrhizal fungus in a 52-million-year-old piece of Indian amber. The amber piece originated from typical broadleaf tree of the Eocene, which was one of the warmest periods in Earth's history. This is an important finding because until then, the only other fossil ectomycorrhiza had been found on the fossilized roots of a coniferous tree from the Vancouver Islands, dated to 50 million years old. This shows that at the same time, ectomycorrhiza occurred not only in geographically distinct areas, but also with different symbiotic tree partners. Broadleaf tree in present-day India and coniferous tree in present-day Canada. If all ectomycorrhiza fungi share a common ancestor, we can assume a long evolutionary history of ectomycorrhiza partnerships. Maybe even since plants conquered the land?